Hello friends, welcome all of you. In previous lecture, we discuss on effect of impurity and temperature on surface tension, excess pressure across the free surface of liquid, and also the formation of drops and bubbles. So today we discuss the new point of this topic. So let's start today's lecture. First, we see today's discussion point. Today we discuss the major point or the main point of this topic, and the point it is the capillary action. In capillary action point, we see capillary rise and capillary fall, and also mathematical expression for this point. So let's see one by one. First, we see what is meant by capillary. Before this, capillaries in the Latin means it is the hair-like structure. So first we see definition of this capillary: a tube having a very fine bore, that means approximately 1 millimeter, and open at both the ends, it is called as the capillary tube. Once again, we recall definition: a tube having very fine bore and open at both ends, it is called as the capillary tube. Let's see diagram for this. This is the capillary, both ends are open. Let's see one again, the cross section of this bore. This is very fine structure, glass capillary, open at both ends. And see, bore it is very small, approximately 0.1 centimeter is its radius. Let's see. Here, capillary, it is deeper in a pure water, which is partially or completely wets the solid. Liquid level in the capillary tube, it is the rises. So, it is called as the capillary rise. Remember, if one end of the capillary tube is deeper in a liquid, which is partially or completely wets the solid, liquid level in the capillary rises, it is called as the capillary rise. Let's see, tube it is deeper in the mercury. When capillary tube it is deeper in the liquid which does not wet the solid, liquid level in the capillary drops down, it is called as the capillary depression. When capillary tube it is inserted in the pure water which is partially or completely wet the solid, liquid level in the capillary tube it is rises, it is called as the capillary rise. And when capillary tube it is deeper in mercury, the capillary level it is dropped down, or liquid level in the capillary it is dropped down, it is called as the capillary depression. See this image, this one is the original capillary tube. When one end of the capillary tube it is deeper in the pure water, liquid level in the capillary tube it is rises. See, this one is the meniscus and very small radius of the capillary tube. See one more image, capillary tube deeper in a liquid, capillary level in the liquid it is the rise, it is called as a capillary rise. And when capillary it is deeper in the mercury, liquid level in the capillary drops down, it is called as the capillary fall. The next point is the what is meant by capillarity. Let's see definition of this. The phenomenon of rise or fall of a liquid inside a capillary tube when it is deeper in the liquid, it is called as the capillarity. The phenomenon of rise or fall of a liquid inside a capillary tube, it is called as the capillarity. Let's see the application. There are various applications of this capillarity. First application, it is the oil rises up the wick of a lamp. Water rises up the crevices in the rocks. Blotting paper absorbs ink. And sap and water rise up to the topmost leaves in a tree. Let's see images for this. The first immunity is the oil rises up the wing of a lamp. It is due to the capillarity action. Next one is the cloth rags sucks the water. It is also due to capillarity action. Next C image, water rises up crevices in the rocks. It is also due to the capillarity action. And the next image, it is the sap and water rises up to the topmost leaves in a tree. It is also due to the effect of the capillarity action. So let's see the next point. Next point is the capillarity action. When capillary is deeper in a liquid, two effects can be observed. Let's see what are these two effects. The first, it is the rise of a liquid inside the capillary, and second, it is the fall of a liquid inside the capillary tube. So let's see one by one this capillary action. First, we see rise of a liquid. See this diagram. When a capillary tube is deeper in a liquid which is partially or completely wets the solid, there is capillary rise and liquid meniscus inside the tube. It is the concave. Let's see first image. When capillary tube is deeper in a liquid which is partially or completely wets the solid, capillary rise is observed up to the some height h. So let's see here some points, point A, point B, point C and point D. Point A is just above the concave meniscus inside the capillary. Point B is just below the concave meniscus inside the capillary tube. Point C is just above the free surface of the liquid outside the capillary tube. And point D is just below the free surface of the liquid outside the capillary tube. So here let's see P of A, P of B, P of C and P of D. That means pressure at point A, pressure at point B, pressure at point C and pressure at point D. Let's see, as we know that pressure at point A is equals to pressure at point C. That means because it is due to the atmospheric pressure. So here PC is equals to also PD because free surface of the liquid pressure remains the constant. So as PA is equals to PC and PC is equals to PD, that means PA is equals to PD, or it is also called as pressure at point A is equals to pressure at point D. As we know that we see in the previous lecture, pressure on concave side of the meniscus, it is always greater than on the convex side. So pressure at point A is greater than the pressure at point B. As seen in the figure, as points B and D are at the same horizontal level inside the tube, pressure at point D, it is greater than the pressure at point B. So liquid flows into the capillary and rises above the point B till the pressure at B becomes same as that of the pressure at point D. So here PD is greater than the PB, or simply we can call it as the pressure at point B is equals to pressure at point D. Let's see the next point. It is the fall of a liquid. For a non-wetting liquid, there is a capillary depression. Liquid meniscus in the capillary tube, it is the convex. So when capillary it is deeper in the mercury, there is observation. It is mercury level or liquid level in the capillary tube, it is the drops down. So here also four points, point A, point B, point C and point D. Point A, it is just above the concave meniscus. Point B, it is just below the concave meniscus. Point C, it is above the free surface of the liquid outside the capillary tube. And point D is just below the free surface of the liquid outside the capillary tube. So as we know that pressure on concave side is greater than the pressure on the convex side. So here also pressure at point B, it is greater than the pressure at point A. So as we know that pressure at point A is equals to pressure at point C, that means PA is equals to PC. So we can conclude that pressure at point C is equals to pressure at point D is equals to pressure at point A, that means PC is equals to PD is equals to P of A. So from this pressure at point B, it is greater than the pressure at point D. So let's see the next point. Next point is the expression for capillary rise or the capillary fall. So there are two methods we discuss in brief. First method, it is the using pressure difference technique, and the second method, it is the using forces. So expression for capillary rise or fall we can determine in the two ways, using pressure difference and using forces. So let's see one by one. First technique, it is the expression for capillary rise for a liquid, that means using pressure difference. Let's see image first. Here capillary tube, it is dipped in a liquid which is completely or partially wets the solid. Liquid level inside the capillary tube, it becomes rises. When capillary tube of radius small r, see in the figure, radius it is the small r, dipped in a liquid of density rho, small h, it is the capillary rise. Theta, see in the figure, theta is the angle of contact at edge of the concave meniscus and the glass tube. And capital R, it is the radius of curvature of the meniscus. So as we know that gauge pressure or pressure difference having the formula P minus P0 is equals to rho G into the small h. And also we saw in the last previous lecture, Laplace's law for the spherical membrane of the liquid drop having the formula P minus P0 is equals to twice T divided by the capital R. See in this figure, small r and capital R here contains small angle theta. So cos of theta for this is equals to small r divided by the capital R. From this we calculate capital R is equals to small r divided by cos of the theta. So first equation P minus P0 is equals to rho gh, and second equation it is the P minus P0 is equals to twice T divided by the capital R. So equating these two equations we have to get, that means H rho G is equals to twice T divided by the capital R. So capital R is nothing but R divided by cos of the theta. So putting this value in the equation, we have to get H rho G is equals to twice T cos theta divided by the simply small r. So outside taking, that means simplifying this equation, we have to get small h is equals to twice T cos theta divided by the R rho into the G. So from this we have concluded that h, that means height of the liquid column, and the radius, these are in the inverse relation. That means when height increases, radius should be small, or vice versa, that means when R it is decreases, height becomes increases. So this one is the one method for capillary rise using pressure difference technique. Let's see the next point. Expression for capillary rise for a liquid using forces. See this diagram here, same capillary tube, it is dipped in your pure water which is partially or completely wets the solid, and liquid level in the capillary tube, it becomes rises. So here also capillary tube of radius small r, dipped in a liquid of density rho, h it is the capillary rise, and theta it is the angle of the contact. So here, according to the Newton's third law of the motion, capillary wall exerts an equal and opposite reaction on the liquid. So wet of the liquid column, see in the figure, this one is the wet of the liquid column must be equal to the opposite forces due to the surface tension at the point of the contact. So here vertical component, that means f of t cos of theta, it is balanced by the weight of the liquid column, that means m into the small g. So force due to surface tension, it is given by the formula f of t is equals to surface tension into the length of the contact. So here length of contact inside the capillary tube, it is nothing but the circumference of the tube, that means 2 pi into the small r. So we can write equation in this form: force due to surface tension, that means f of t is equals to t into the 2 pi r. So direction of this force is along the tangent. So we can write this equation in terms of f of t vertical is equals to t into the 2 pi r into the cos of the theta. So as we know that volume of the cylinder or volume of the capillary tube is equals to v is equals to pi r square into the small h. So as we know that weight is equals to mg, m in terms of the density, that means rho into the capital V into the small g. So W, that means weight, having the formula pi r square h into rho into the small g. So here net vertical upward force must be balances or which is equals to weight of the liquid column. So we can write the equation, that means pi r square h rho g is equals to t, that means vertical component, t into the 2 pi r into the cos of the theta. So solving this term, we have to get, that means outside taking the height term, h is equals to twice t cos theta divided by the rho, that means r rho into the small g. So outside taking the surface tension term, that means t is equals to h r rho g divided by the 2 times cos of the theta. So let's see, these are the different capillary rise inside the tube. See here, this one is the capillary rise having the very small, and radius and height, these are in the inverse relation. Narrower the capillary tube, greater is the capillary rise. So we solve example 1. Let's see. Calculate the rise of water in a clean glass capillary tube of radius 0.1 millimeter when dipped into water of surface tension 7 into 10 raised to minus 2 newton per meter. Angle of contact between water and glass is equals to 0. Density of water is equals to 1000 kilogram per meter cube, and acceleration due to gravity having the value 9.8 meter per second square. So let's see. Given data first, radius given, that means small r is equals to 0.1 millimeter, that means 1 into 10 raised to minus 4 meter. Theta given, it is the 0 degree, that means cos of theta is equals to 1. Surface tension 7 into 10 raised to minus 2 newton per meter. Density, that means rho, is equals to 1000 kilogram per meter cube, and small g, it is 9.8 meter per second square. So we have to find out here the capillary rise, that means the height. So first we have to write the formula for this. Formula is nothing but h is equals to twice t cos theta divided by rho r into the small g. So solve the example. Let's see first. Again, formula h is equals to twice t cos theta divided by rho r into the small g. So putting these values given in the data, we have to write h is equals to 2 into 7 into 10 raised to minus 2 into the 1 divided by 1000, that means rho, is into 1 into 10 raised to minus 4 into the 9.8. So calculating these values, we have to get the height, that means the capillary rise, in the SI form, and the final answer, it is the h is equals to 0.143 meter. So this one is the one example we have to see. So from this, today's highlight point of this lecture, it is very important point for your various entrance exam. The height of the liquid column in a capillary tube on the moon is 6 times that on the earth. And the next highlight point is the lesser the radius of the capillary, greater will be its rise. This is called as the Jurien's law. So friends, today we discuss the interesting point of this topic. In the next video, we discuss the new point of this topic.